Welcome to the enchanting seaside town of Budva, Montenegro, where modern high-rise condos and a picturesque old town stand side by side against the stunning blue waters of the Adriatic Sea. So in this video, we'll dive into the heart of Budva, uncovering its most captivating sights, mouth-watering dining spots, and unbeatable accommodations, all while showcasing just how affordable this dream destination can be. So buckle up and get ready to explore Budva like never before, all in this episode of Lucas World Travel. Travelers, it's Kendra and David here with Lucas World Travel, and in this episode, we're taking you to Budva, Montenegro. Now, we're here in December, but nonetheless, it is gorgeous. So, when you come in high season in the summer, you're gonna love the views.
So, as we travel, we see many people like us traveling. They're coming to these places, even on off season, and they're enjoying them and having a great time.
Yeah.
The places aren't busy, and you can see everything. So don't let the weather and don't let off-season turn you off.
Our first stop was to Old Town Budva with its charming city walls. As you walk into the Iron Gate, you will be greeted by narrow streets and charming stone architecture. Some of the best sites in the Old Town include the Church of St. John, the Holy Trinity Church, and the Citadal, which is a museum and fortress with lovely views. Going inside the Citadel, you will see nautical exhibits as well as an impressive library. Our favorite part of the Citadel, though, has to be walking the walls to see the fantastic views of St. Nicholas Island as well as the surrounding city. An entrance into the Citadel is 350 euro. And now we're back into the modern world. So Pisana Beach is a tiny beach right next to the old town. So it's nice that you can see St. Nicola behind us and also Old Town on that side as well. But it's so tiny, I would just go ahead and go to Mogren Beach. I think you'll enjoy that one even better. For lunch, though, we found a nice restaurant right on the water.
So now we're at the Fisherman's Pub, and we just love to go places that have good views. So we're right here by the water, able to see all the fishing boats, and able to see Old Town right over there, too. It's quite lovely.
Mm-hmm. So our food came. David got his vegetarian pizza. And I got a tuna salad, but it's with real tuna. Doesn't that look so good? Yum. Seriously though, this is some of the best tuna I've ever had. Excellent. After lunch, we decided to check out the beautiful views from the Mogren Beach footway.
So from the old town, Mogren Beach is just 300 meters that way.
Along the trail, you'll see beautiful rock formations as well as the Budva dancer. Now, I love how they put a beautiful statue in such a beautiful landscape. It makes it even more gorgeous. Loving this walk so far. Let's see what else there is. I'm going to try to replicate the dancer right here.
Not bad, actually.
And just like that, we've made it to Mogren Beach. What an amazing beach this is, though, guys. It's gorgeous. Even in the winter. The next day we woke up to snow-capped mountains.
As you can see, the mountains behind me are beautifully snow-capped. It just snowed last night. Even though it's December, it's still moderately temperatured. So where we are, it's about 50 degrees. So still very comfortable considering it's December. Now, another thing we recommend you do is to walk down the Budva Riviera. This little coastal walkway is filled with great sea views and adorable restaurants. So now we're at Zelini Guy Restaurant. We chose this place just because it has such a pretty view right on the sand. So today I'm gonna try a Serbian dish. It's a stew with meat and mixed vegetables. Leskovačka mučkalica. David's gonna have the fried calamari, and we're gonna share a green salad. So our first thing has arrived, and it is a green salad. So here we are. And it looks quite spectacular. Party. And David has the fried calamari. Now, technically, I already forgot the name of this dish, but we're gonna try it out.
Jessica, some mystery.
So good. So much savory flavor. That's good. I'm very glad I ordered this. Super delicious and nice on a winter day. And how's your calamari?
This is probably the best calamari I've ever had. It's really tasty. Seriously, it's really tasty, and I have this all the time, so this is really, really good.
All right, so it's official. We can highly recommend this place. Very good dishes. Now that one was extremely delicious. The next day we had beautiful weather, so decided to walk to Fort Mogren. Now this fortress is about 25 minute walk away from Old Town. Along the way we found a restaurant with a spectacular view called Restaurant Vista Bitikovac. So because we're walking, we were able to see that beautiful restaurant and viewpoint along the way to Fort Mogren. So when you arrive, you can just walk straight up the hill into the fortress. The fortress is abandoned, so there's no admission. You can just enjoy these beautiful views for free. So now we're on a real adventure, guys. So from the fortress, there's a trail going down the hill. We have no idea where this trail goes, but we think it goes to a beach. And because it's a beautiful day, why not take the trail to the beach? So we're slowly, hopefully carefully, making our way down. Let's see what's at the end. Something or nothing. All right, so it doesn't lead to a beach. But look at this viewpoint. Oh, that's chilling. Look at the cliff beneath me. It's super pretty though. So this is what happens the more and more you travel. You get a little bit more adventurous and you try to go down those mysterious trails that you have no idea what's at the end. Now, I do believe that there was a way to continue along the edge, but we saw enough of a view. And we're gonna head back up to our next stop. After leaving the fortress, we walked a kilometer back into Budva in order to take the bus to our next stop, Saint Stefan. This is the bus stop you want to wait at. So tickets on the minibus are 2 euros a piece. So from the bus stop, you can see
the island already.
And you want to take the stairs down.
So, Sveti Stefan has two lovely beaches on either side of its small strip of land that leads out to the island. They wound up selling the resort to a private company, Aman, in 2008, and it's been a private resort ever since. So, you can only go onto the actual city unless you have a reservation at the five-star resort. But you can still come enjoy the views and enjoy the beaches here, which are lovely. And while seeing the city from eye level is great, seeing it from above is even better. That's why we can highly recommend going to Hotel Adriatic for a great view and for good food as well.
So now we're at Hotel Adriatic. So we got a salmon with spinach pasta. Looks good.
It does look good. The noodles are perfect. It's very creamy, very cheesy. And it has subtle hints of the salmon, which is really nice. I like it. It's really good.
Plus, the restaurant has a great view from its rooftop terrace as well. If you manage to get all the way up here.
But before we leave the beautiful views of Budva, let's show you just how affordable accommodations in Budva can be. So now, let's show you around our accommodation in Budva. We have our living room, dining room, kitchen area. If you haven't figured it out, I love these types of sectional sofas. I think they're so comfortable. And David has his fancy yellow chair to sit in. And we have a dining room set, full kitchen with a hidden fridge over here. And we even have a decent view. Not a full sea view, but a partial one. So you can see all of the city there, the road. And we got one little couple of feet of sea right there. We also have a queen-sized bed, which looks quite comfy, and a full bathroom. And with our favorite, it has a washing machine. And we got this lovely apartment for $31 a night. I'm really loving these very low season prices. So you don't get the best weather, but you get some great rates when you travel in the off season. From wandering the cobblestone streets to indulging in delicious cuisine, our journey through Budva was nothing short of magical. So I hope this video inspired you to add Budva to your Montenegro itinerary, because this little town is big with beauty. Up next, we're gonna be going to Tirana, Albania. So make sure to hit that red subscribe button and the bell so you can follow along with the journey. And if you have your own Montenegro and Budva tips, share those in the comments below for your fellow travelers. As always, guys, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next journey. But no trip to Montenegro is complete without visiting Kotor, so be sure to check out our Kotor guide on the right there. As always, thanks so much for watching, thanks for sharing with all your travel pals, and happy travel planning. Until next time.